Hello and welcome to Mr. Manley History Teacher's latest video on how to successfully answer the AQA This Sort Supports or Opposes the style question. And this is a source-based question that will be in the conflict and tension 1918 to 1939 GCSE paper. So let's get started. Now, this question is only worth 4 marks. So it's a smaller GCSE style question. And because of the fact it's only worth 4 marks, you're only expected to spend about 5 minutes answering this type of question. And the question will be formatted as follows. Source A opposes or supports something in particular. How do you know? Explain your answer using the source and also your own contextual knowledge. And really, this is the most important part, the fact that you have to, as I've said in my top tips here, use both the source itself and your contextual knowledge. Let's run through these top tips individually now as well. So, first main piece of advice is to read the question really carefully. Make sure you answer the question directly. Don't be sidetracked into answering about another topic that the question is related to. Make sure you stick to the topic in the question itself. Secondly, as I mentioned already, make sure you use both the content, so what you can either see if it's a visual source like a cartoon or a drawing, or if it's a written source, you can use a quote from the source or a sentence. So you need to use both that and also your own contextual knowledge in your answer. If you only do one of those, the maximum amount of marks you can probably achieve is 2 out of 4. However, if you use both the contents of the source and your own contextual knowledge, you can get 4 marks out of 4. Like I've mentioned, you don't want to spend too long writing your answer to this question. It's only a 4 mark question, so we want to spend a maximum of 5 minutes answering it. Okay, so the main tips to answer this type of question. Let's have a look now at a model answer. Right, so the model answer is as follows to the following question. Source A opposes the Treaty of Versailles. How can you tell? Explain using source A and your own contextual knowledge. So similarly to the example that we saw on the second slide, on which was asking about source A opposes Germany. How can you tell? Explain using the source of your contextual knowledge. This time it's about the Treaty of Versailles. So you really need to focus in on the topic on this of this question, which is, in this example, on the Treaty of Versailles. Now, let's have a look at the source itself. We can see someone here on the left-hand side. It might be quite difficult to see the writing in this source, but this person here is representing Germany. So I'll highlight him in yellow. He's representing Germany. Now, the words on the fingers of the hand holding or grasping this person are America, Italy, Japan, France, and the British Empire. So we've got the winning countries of the First World War here. And then it says in the speech bubble, you've got to swallow it whether you like it or not, being the peace terms of the Treaty of Versailles. So we can tell from this source, and we can actually see in the source itself, that someone representing Germany is being forced to accept the peace terms of the Treaty of Versailles. And that's how we're going to start our answer. So source A opposes the Treaty of Versailles. How can we tell? Well, we can tell because within the source, we can see someone representing Germany being forced to accept the terms of the Treaty of Versailles. And by doing that, writing what we can see in the source, we're already explaining using source A. So that's the first part done. Fantastic. But as it says in the question, we've also got to use our own contextual knowledge. So to do that, we then need to link our own contextual knowledge with what we can see in the source. And we can see in the source that Germany's being forced to accept the terms of the Treaty of Versailles. And we know from our own knowledge that Germany was not invited to the Paris Peace Conference where the terms of the Treaty of Versailles were decided. And essentially, they had no option other than to accept the terms of the treaty. To really impress the marker, you might use a term or a phrase that demonstrates excellent own knowledge. And here we've got the term diktat or dictated peace. So the German people refer to this forcing onto the German state of the peace terms as the diktat or dictated peace. And that is literally it in terms of what you need to do to answer this type of question. So if you liked what you heard during the video and you feel like it's helped you understand how to answer this question better, give the video a like, and if you haven't subscribed, subscribe to my channel, Mr. Manley History Teacher. Thanks for listening.